فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Praise Allah سبحانه وتعالى and he's the only one worthy of praise. I seek his help, his guidance, and his forgiveness. I believe in him and I trust him. I seek refuge in Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship other than Allah Rabbil Alameen, and I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah, have the taqwa of Allah, and don't die unless you are in the state of Al-Islam. Inshallah, this khutbah will be the fourth khutbah concerning money. And money is very important and very serious. We talk about it three times, and inshallah, we add one khutbah more, so we can be more careful with the money, especially after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had warned us against property, against money, gold, silver, dollar, and he said what the meaning is, لِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ فِتْنَةٍ وَفِتْنَةُ أُمَّةِ الْمَالِ. Every nation, every community has a fitna, a trial, temptation, a means of deviation. And the fitna of my ummah is in the wealth, in the money. With a verse from Surah Al-A'raf that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, يَا بَنِي آدَمَ خُذُوا زِينَتَكُمْ عِنْدَ كُلِّ مَسْجِدٍ وَكُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا وَلَا تُسْرِفُوا إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُسْرِفِينَ. Surah Al-A'raf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given us a direction, instruction. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leading us to the best way and the guided way. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, that take the best of your adornment at the time of all prayer or places of worship. Eat and drink, and don't be wasteful. We see in this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us about direction, guidance. For all people, all mankind, have to have the proper respect, honoring the worship of Allah, honoring the places of Allah, which one of them is Jum'ah. When you come to Jum'ah, this is your weekly feast. You should come in the best fashion and the best manner, the most cleanest and newest clothes that you have. Taking a shower, putting perfume, using the miswak. Why? Because you're going for the worship of Allah. You're going to be sitting among the believers and with the believers. And you have to be in the best condition, looks and smell. And also you're going to be in the place where the angels most gathering in this moment, assembly like this, is witness, wa shahidin wa mashhud. So the angels will be here to listen to the khutbah and to hear the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are not going to the White House or the Blue House. You're going to the best place in the whole earth. You come into the mosque of Allah. وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. Those people who honor and respect and give more value to the assembles of Allah and the places of Allah and things that have been honored by Allah. This part of the taqwa. This part of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't come to khutbah Jum'ah or to the mosque smelling like what? Or your socks smell like what? Or that you was just jogging, getting your exercise? No, you coming to the best. You coming for the remembrance of Allah. إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمْعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعَ. You coming for the remembrance of Allah. You have to come in the best fashion. Did you brush your hair? Did you comb your beard? Did you put your perfume? Same thing when you're going for Eid, the same thing that you're going for any Muslim in gatherings, that you have to be concerned about the way how you look and the way how you smell. And these verses came after those people with their jahiliyyah mentality. They say, they go to the Kaaba, they go to the Haram, naked. Because they feel that they are not supposed to approach the houses of Allah in clothes that they sin in it. But Allah orders them to get the best adornment when they go, when they worship. And we say and remind also our sisters that when they come to the mosque, this is not a disco, this is not a nightclub. This is a place of worship. This is a place of respect and honor. Imam, why are you saying this? I'm wearing my pants. No, you are not wearing. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Kasiyatun ariyat." He had informed us about women that they will be dressed, but they are naked. They dressed because you could not see the color of their skin, but they are naked because they can see the shade of their body. So any Muslim woman to dare to come to the house of Allah is no taqwa in the qulub, in the hearts, no fear of Allah, no respect, not for the house of Allah, not for the believers, not for the imams, not for the gathering of the Muslims. It's better for you to stay home. It's better for you to stay home. Or she come in with perfume. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had told us about a woman going outside of her house with perfume equal to a woman that commit adultery. So what is the instruction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Get the best adornment when you going for the salah. Even if in your house. Even if you are in your own house. Don't stand up making salat al-zuhr wearing your t-shirt. You are communicating with Allah. You're standing there in a position, doesn't matter if a mosque or a house, you still have in munajah, and you have a talking and conversation, a private session with Allah. How you talk standing with a short and t-shirt? And after this, making your salah. Oh, brother, so I have to open the closet and get my jilbab, get my soap, and get my coffee, and get... You don't know. You're standing before Allah. خُذُوا زِينَتَكُمْ is order. Allah telling you, anytime you're approaching Allah, making salah, going to the mosque, indulging in any form of worship, that you need to have the best of your adornment. What else Allah said? قُلُوا وَشْرَبُوا. Eat and drink. And we say, Alhamdulillah, that this deen, it don't prevent or deprive us from eating or drinking. It is reality. It is from Allah. He knows the needs and the wants of the human being. But also Allah, when He told you to eat and drink, He said, وَلَا تُسْرِفُوا. Don't be spendthrift. Don't be wasting. This is something very important we need to take into consideration. Because this is, it shows appreciation to the ni'mah of Allah. Allah give you food. Allah give you juice. Allah give you water. Allah give you milk. So, don't be wasteful. Remember the people who live overseas. Remember the people who did not have a clean water, not to wash dishes, clean water to drink. Remember the people who go with cups and buckets, looking for a place of rain to get some water, waiting for this. قُلُوا وَشْرَبُوا وَلَا تُسْرِفُوا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُسْرِفِينَ. You want to be loved by Allah? Don't be wasteful. Don't be wasteful. Be grateful. The food and the drinks that Allah give you, use it accordingly. And we have two things here that we're talking about. When we talk about money and wealth, that we need to take in consideration. One called Israf and one called Tabdhir. And both of them is not appreciated in Islam. Not the Israf, not the Tabdhir. Somebody may ask, what is the difference? Israf, that you go beyond the necessity or the needs. And the Tabdhir is using it in the haram. And both of them, they are not appreciated. I may give example about somebody making israf, even in the ta'ah and the obedience of Allah, making wudu, as if he's taking a shower. Look to the faucet, how been open, running, and he take his time or her time, looking in the mirror or moving their watch and getting their glasses off, and the water is running, it's waste. Yes, you're going to make wudu, but why? Why are you turning the water, you understand, 2-3 minutes before you start your wudu? And can you turn the water off, as example, a little bit? You are not wet, paying the water bill, the masjid is paying, so, but still, even if you are using a river, if you're standing on a river to make wudu, because when we are not paying attention, how we behaving is going to be part of our habit and our daily life. Even if you are sitting on a river to make ablution, take what is needed for you to make wudu. 1 cup, 2 cups, 3 cups, 5 cups. So why a whole bucket to make wudu? Why? This, you're using it for the obedience of Allah, for the ta'ah of Allah, to make ablution, to approach your prayer. You use it for a right purpose, but beyond your necessity. A husband, a wife, and a child, and a cat, and build a house with 7 rooms. For what? Whether I have the money. I have the money. Yes. Even if you give a room for yourself, and a room for your wife, and a room for your daughter, and even a room for the cat. I'm not going to say a dog. Okay? What is the other? Oh, brother, sometimes we have a guess. Sometimes. In the last 10 years, how many guests came to your house after you built the house? Okay? We're going to keep a room also for the guests, in case a guest will come. What about the other 2 rooms? So it's halal, but wasting. You have people living between mountains because all these wars and all this destruction and all these revolutions going almost everywhere, especially among the Muslims. They don't even have a tent. They don't have a tent. And after this, when you say, brother, yes, I'm looking for a house. How many bedroom, brothers? How many? 7, 8 rooms. Why? What are you going to do with all this? What are you going to do with all this? Brother, is this? You need to relax. How far are you going to relax? How much you can extend your feet or sit or where? You are not going to play basketball inside the house. So instead, this called israf. You can eat lunch, but why 2 pounds of rice? Why 10 cups of rice been cooked? Where is the rest is going? In the trash. No, we don't have, we have garbage disposal. This is where it's going to the soish. I'm telling you, there is Muslims living, they, if Allah bless them with a breakfast, they are not going to have lunch, neither a dinner. While you're living in this luxury and living in this convenience and all this food, and one of the worst things that we speak, especially see with some of the students coming from overseas, because they are not sweating to make the money, getting 1,000, 1,500, whatever, from his country to come to learn and understand English and maybe go to school or whatever. So what? They worship in something called fashion. In every day, every week, in the weekend, he has nothing to do. So now he goes to the mall, buying this, buying that, buying this. A new pants, now with cuffs, no cuffs, now with this and that. This worship in fashion. Anything comes in you, in the shirt, so the shirt have to be changed. And after this, almost every month, a big garbage bag with clothes. And some of them still have the tag on it, it's not been wear, and dump it. Brother is going for goodwill. Yeah, but you know how much he pay for each shirt? Some of the shirts, this is called israf. And this is not from the deen. You have to start to think and be grateful, because Allah is saying, in Allah la yuhibbu al-musrifin. Allah doesn't like those people who are wasteful. But now if you want to talk about tabdhir, now people are spending money in something that is not benefiting them in their life, neither in the hereafter. And this is worse. To such a degree that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said what? إِنَّ الْمُبَذِّرِينَ كَانُوا إِخْوَانَ الشَّيَاطِينَ. Would you like somebody to label you as a shaitan? You are behaving in a manner of shaitan, devil. What is shaitan? وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِرَبِّهِ كَفُورًا. It's a disbeliever. Part of God's creation, the disbelief in Allah, acting in kufr. So don't be a kafir in your action, not in your aqidah. Don't be a kafir in your action. As the Prophet ﷺ said to the Sahaba women in the day of Eid, he said, تَصَدَّقْنَا فَإِنِّي رَأَيْتُكُنَّ أَكْثَرَ أَهْلِ النَّارِ. Give in charity, I saw you to be the most dweller of hellfire. He said, why, O Prophet of Allah? I said, because تَكْفُرْن, that because you disbelieve. He said, O Prophet of Allah, بِاللَّه, we disbelieve in Allah? He said, no, تَكْفُرْنَ الْعَشِيرِ, being ungrateful to your husband. So being ungrateful to Allah's favor, or those who bestow blessing on you or a favor towards you, this is called a form of kufr in amali, kufr amali, not i'tiqadi, not in aqidah. And this is not appreciated, not acceptable, not welcome in al-Islam. So you have to be thankful to what Allah gave you. Now, you acting in a mannerism and behaving like a shaitan, وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِرَبِّهِ كَفُورًا, and the shaitan is a kafir. And I give you examples about tabvir, which is more worse than israf, spending money in alcohol, drinking. What kind of a benefit gives you? Making you feel good? Does it make you gain weight? Does it make you stronger? Does it make you more wiser? What's the benefit of it? Drugs. Buying drugs, taking drugs. What does it benefit you? Smoking cigarette, which became common among most of the teenagers, boys and some girls. Smoking. Buying destruction for your own health. All these things is called tabzir. And this is not acceptable in Islam. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى كَرِهَ لَكُمْ ثَلَاثَ قِيلَ وَقَالَ وَكَثْرَةَ السُّؤَالِ وَإِضَاعَةِ الْمَالِ. Allah dislike to see you behaving in such manner. In three things. He said, she said, we have nothing other than sit down and keep chatting, talking. We don't even have to go travel or go next door. Now we understand the phone. And now all the convenience that you don't even have to hold the phone anymore. Okay? You can put the Bluetooth or whatever you call it in your ear and you still understand. Jogging or running or playing or whatever that you're doing and talking about what? Nothing except gossip. And if it's not gossip, what you're talking about is going to lead you to gossiping. Because he said, she said, they bought that house, they lost that house, they got this car, I don't know how they can pay for all the things, but she got married and the other one got divorced. And this, and guess what? And talking about the people, Allah dislikes this. Can you remind each other about Allah? Can you encourage each other about towards the Akhirah and doing something for the Muslims in general, or serving the mosque? Can you talk about something beneficial? Can you give da'wah over the phone? Nothing. قِيلَ وَقَالَ, he said, she said. وَكَثْرَةَ السُّؤَالِ, too many questions. About things doesn't even relate to you. It's not your business. Be nosy. Being nosy is not part of Islam. What else Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislike for Muslims to behave in? Ida'at al-mal. Wasting the money. Some people dying to make a dollar. Dying, I mean it. Especially here in South Carolina.
It's very bad to make a dollar. All what they're looking for, $3. I'm telling you, you think I'm lying. I'm telling you, I live almost in the mosque. I see the people day and night. There are some people could not make $3 a day. All what he want, he or she, to buy a candy bar and a cup of coffee. And maybe you give him a $3 today, but tomorrow who's going to give him the other $3? Neither somebody have a job for him, neither he can find a job. Especially if the person been commit a crime before he became Muslim or whatever it is. Now they go looking for jobs, nobody want to take them. And while some people could not have $3 a day, that you're spending all this money in something is not beneficial for you or for others. Be ungrateful to Allah by using the ni'mah and the blessing of Allah in something displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want to take a quick minute, and already time is running, specifically about cigarette today, smoking cigarette. People go to the hospital to be cured from cancer and cured from illness and disease and microbes and germs, while you buying something to make you sick, now or later. Something to cause you sickness and illness. What is the benefit of cigar? What is the benefit of smoking? Tell me, in your deen, in your dunya, in your health, for the Muslim community or for the kafir, even the kafir, they know how serious is smoking. You could not smoke anymore in an airplane. You could not smoke anymore. Now they have designated area. And from day one, when they sold you the package, if you read it, it says it's not good for you. You can see this. So those who made it, they're telling you that it's not good for you. And you know it's not going to help you anything. So instead, turning to Allah when you have the problem, you're turning for some trash in piece of paper. This was a brother. I have a lot of problems. I could not find jobs. My wife divorced me. My wife left the house. Oh. And we keep saying all kind of problems. So this little trash that been in a piece of paper that you're burning your lungs and your tongues and everything with it, is going to solve your problem? Wake up! Wake up! The kuffar already knows the danger of it and finally decide to do something about it. When the Muslims going to stop? When they going to stop? Buying, selling, using, offering, subhanAllah, offering to each other. Who's my best friend here? Walla. Subhanallah. How you can give somebody? Even kids, they understand when they eating lollipop or candy. If somebody suck out one, the other one say no, you touch it with your hand. And you giving to somebody cigarette. How you can do this? Smoking cigarette, you are wasting the money. You are acting in a shaitanic manner. You are ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Think about you put this cigarette in your mouth. Think about people in Somalia. Think about the people in Egypt, in Syria, in Iraq. Think about these people who did not have money to eat while you enjoying the haram. And also a person who's smoking is a person who publicizing his sin. Because listen, something that you're doing is halal or haram. It's pleasing to Allah or displeasing to Allah. So why are you not hiding with your sin? Now you're walking in a public street, in different places, in front of your friends and your families, and you're smoking. Now you're publicizing your sin. So three crimes. And number four is that you've been ungrateful to the money that Allah had make it, gave it to you. Five crimes in smoking cigarette. And after all this, what you're doing, you're destroying your health. So there's six crimes. When you're going to stop? When you're going to stop? And please kindly, please kindly, like I said, and always been the habit of this mask. Anything inside the fence is a place, the property of Islamic Center of Colombia. Do not be a good example, do not be a bad example for Muslim children. Don't show them that adult is smoking cigarette. You have a problem, get in your car, drive out of the property, and do whatever you want outside. But I'm telling you, we've been establishing rules and regulation here. And we say that it's no smoking in the property of the mosque. Property of the mosque, anything inside the fence, this is the property of Islamic Center of Colombia. You are not allowed to do this. I don't have to be careful to impose something in you and make you do it. You need to respect me as a Muslim and to listen. Is not my desire, but you are giving a bad example for the teenagers, boys and girls and the little kids, that it's okay. You want to enjoy your lunch and your cigarette in the same time. You're doing the halal and the haram mixing together in the same time. So please take this in consideration and care for yourself and care for the environment. Now the non-Muslims themselves talking about environment now. When is a Muslim going to talk about environment? When is a Muslim going to be part of cleaning the environment and not to pollute the environment and have a fresh, clean air for the people to breathe? When? We're supposed to be leading this effort not to be corrupting the environment. And lastly, you come in here in the mosque, you're making sujood, and you say, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. Do you know when you open your mouth, I smell it. It doesn't disturb you because you are a smoker. But since I never smoke, it's easy to smell it. It disturbs me. Guess what? It disturbs the angels also. So don't be a disturbance for the Muslims. Don't be a disturbance for the angels. It is the place of Allah. And I'm telling you one thing. When you come, take your jacket off and leave it inside your car. You don't smell yourself, but when you come here, we smell you. And it, wallahi, I was about to cut my salah off and get out of the line. I could not, I was about almost to vomit it because somebody beside me, he doesn't smell himself. But it was affecting me so bad that I was about to leave the salah. It's the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. About fresh garlic and onions. They say, any one of you eat it, don't come to the mosque. Don't come to the mosque. فَلْيَعْتَزِلْنَا وَلْيَعْتَزِلْ مَسْجِدٍ. Let him stay away from us and let him pray in his house. Because you corrupted the environment of the angels and the believers in the mosque. Brothers and sisters, let's be grateful to what Allah gives us. Not to be brothers to the shaitan. Allah give it to you to see how you're going to conduct yourself. The same way Allah gives it to you, Allah can take it away from you. So be careful. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all that we act upon what we heard. Ameen. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa usalli wa sallim ala al-mawu'ith rahmatul lil alameen. I remind you again, especially those who smoking cigarettes, that Allah said, وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِكُمْ رَحِيمًا. Do not kill yourself. Allah is so kind and compassionate towards you. You don't kill yourself, you understand, like a gun, but eventually it's going to destroy you. And you killing yourself a little bit by little bit, and it's still haram. Now we end with the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كُلُوا وتصدقوا والبسوا في غير إسراف ولا مخيلة. Eat and dress, get dressed, have nice clothes, no problem, and give in sadaqa. You have leftover, over your use, do not use it in the disobedience of Allah. Give in charity. Because this is going to be waiting for you there in Yawm al-Qiyamah, in your grave. It will help you. But don't be spendthrift or wasting. So eat and give in charity and wear clothes without being bragging or being wasteful. So we have to understand how we use the ni'mah of Allah and be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For those who would like to participate, inshallah, in Share Islam Day, to help us to have it successful, please meet tomorrow in Salat al-Fajr. We're going to have a discussion about it, inshallah. Brother Umar, alhamdulillah, has joined us today. And this is a blessing of Allah. Allah give him, store his life. May Allah bless you for your dua last week for him. He was us after his heart surgery. Alhamdulillah, and inshallah, all of us keep him and all the Muslims in our dua. And inshallah, you can see him after the salah. Alhamdulillah, was so concerned, just leaving and come to Jummah. Lastly, and say the brother, all the teenagers and boys that would like to participate in any Islamic activity, helping in any shape or form, please get in touch with Brother Rashid and Has. Jazakum Allah khairan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our good deed. Allahumma salli.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا واعتدلوا تراصوا استرجوا العين الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين إيلاف قريش إيلافهم رحلة الشتاء والصيف فليعبدوا رب هذا البيت الذي أطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم
صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الله يتوب عليه.